students all were aware of probably a forthcoming war, but they didn't know when. And so the boys, most of the men on campus, decided to form their own company, and Governor Kirkwood accepted them. So the day came for the departure. And Miss Doran was presenting the flag, and part of her speech read, "We cannot hope to see you all again. We commit the flag to your keeping. We do not bid you to guard it. We know it is safe in your hands, as you have been proud to live under it. If death be your lot, may you die under its folds, and may God protect and prosper you as you defend our color."
Upper Iowa is a deep, long-standing tradition of having an ROTC program here with notoriety, dating all the way back to the Civil War times. And it ran very strongly up and through the early 1980s. The military at Upper Iowa University has strongly embraced 6,500 students, both including on-campus here in Fayette and also to include online students. A number of those students are taking classes at our service centers. Through all of those military service centers, it strengthens Upper Iowa's vision. It strengthens Upper Iowa's commitment to the service member. I know, working with the good folks that take care of service members from around the world, that in fact, service members that are taking classes through Upper Iowa University are well taken care of. After meeting with President Duffy, he made it very clear what his intention was for the future. So today, the Iowa National Guard has offices on campus at Upper Iowa University. But when I think about alum specifically that are prior service, I remember that they laid the groundwork. Some of the things that we are doing are because of alumni speaking up and speaking out. This vision, as it continues to cement and become reality, the Military Veterans Service Center, Veterans Club, and then also a commitment to ROTC here on campus, it will become a reality. It truly is a wonderful time to be a part of seeing the growth and excitement and everything developing, and it's only going to continue to allow all of us veterans to feel like Upper Iowa University is certainly home for our educational needs.